Yes.
Okay. I asked last Wednesday night for someone to look up 42 months, 1,206 days, times, times, and half times, and tell me what you saw in common denominator in. You did, and that is, that's pretty close, yes.
Disability question, not it?
No.
It was kind of like an off-field.
We are going to delve into that. All right. Chapter 11. Here's Linda.
Everywhere you say, you don't have any questions, everybody understood, and I sit here.
And so will the rest of them.
Well, the vision, like the motive that looks like a monster, that is just a vision, right?
Correct.
Okay.
Correct.
Even though the places were destroyed, people were killed, that was just a scare?
That was just a vision, and to tell them what's coming. Not literally, but to tell them in apocalyptic form.
That's what I understood of the vision.
Yes, it's all a book beginning with verse, chapter 6, or book of sentence. Okay, figurative language, used to get us to drive home a point. None of these things, there is no literal dragon, there is no literal monster, there are no literal 200 million horsemen, okay? But you can see where you can get the message behind it, like the last trumpet, or the sixth trumpet, that God has an unlimited amount of resources at his command to judge Rome. And it's spoken this way by saying, he's got 200 million horsemen, and they are some of the most fearsome-looking creatures you've ever seen, and they all work under the command of God. And Rome doesn't stand a chance. Yes. Anybody else got the nerve? Yes, sir.
The only hurt and death to the Romans came from other...
The only hurt?
Yeah, I mean, the scorpion's supposed to hurt the man, so none of that happened, just figurative, and the other countries that destroyed Rome, that's the only destruction or hurt that came to the Roman people, that some of the Christians.
Yeah, okay, but God's people were going to suffer in the process, too. Yes, but they were, there were foreigners that came in and destroyed Rome.
So that's what the Bible was referring to as the locusts of these people, the way they acted?
Well, the locusts, I believe that's back in chapter 9, their effect was darkness. Remember, the smoke came out, and the locusts came out of the darkness, and there were so many that the land remained dark. And does anybody remember how I think I understood that? To be the darkness of sin as punishment? No literal locusts, no.
So no animals were killed?
No literal locusts, no. No, this is just a vision that's passing in front of John's view, and he's describing it to us. That's all that's happening, until these things start coming true, and they shall come to pass how soon? Very shortly. Then those things which were pictured in those exaggerated, fantastic ways in that vision will now come true, but not in the way the vision portrayed them. You know, it will be an external legion, but it won't be 200 million of those horsemen. But still, the point is that Rome doesn't stand a chance when this is let loose upon them. Anyone else have the nerve? All right. Chapter 11. Then there was given to me a measuring rod like a staff, and then someone said, get up and measure the temple of God and the altar. That's the first way of describing the people of God, the temple of God. And those who worship it in it, that's number two, leave out the court which is outside the temple and do not measure it, because it has been given to the nations. That is, people who do not believe. And they will tread underfoot the holy city for 42 months. Now, this is another one of these vision deals. It has almost nothing to do with 42 months time-wise. It has to do with the circumstances or the situation that God is trying to describe with the figure of 42 months. Come on back. Yeah, wait a minute. That's not where I want to go. That's not where I want to go. There it is. The same as 1,260 days and time times and half times. And we'll see in Revelation 12, next chapter we're going to, verse 6 and verse 14, which is a description of the woman, you know, that's out in the wilderness, bringing forth the son that the dragon is trying to kill. And in that verse 6 and verse 14, we'll go ahead and take a look at it. Then the woman fled into the wilderness. And she had a place prepared by God so that she would be nourished for 1,260 days. And I did the math for you, which is 42 months. Eight verses later, but the two wings of the great eagle were given to the woman. This is for her rescue from the dragon, so that she could fly into the wilderness to her place where she was nourished. How long? Time, times, and half a time. So, those two are equal. And we already know that 42 months equals 1,260 days. So those are all referring to the same situation or state of affairs that exists when these numbers are used. Now, times, and half a time in verse 14. You've got one time, and then the next word is times, you got two times. One time plus two times equals three times, and then you got half a time. So there you are with three and a half. How does that relate to the number seven? And this is all the way through. It's half of it. Seven represents what is sacred, perfect, complete. And three and a half is the opposite. Okay, that's what 42 months is. That's three and a half what?
Months.
Yeah, three and a half months. And these are not just coincidences. They just weren't thrown in there so that we could have fun trying to figure this out, which is not easy. But we're going to look at where it's used. Hope you got your Bibles with you. 42 months is used again in chapter 13, verse 5. I think I've got this down. Now, this is where we meet these two terrible, fearsome beasts, one coming up out of the sea, the other one coming up out of the earth a little bit. Earth first, then the sea first, then the earth second. And there was given to him, and that's important too. Who did the giving? God gave the giving. There was given to him
a mouth speaking arrogant words and blasphemy and authority to act for 42 months. So that is an imperfect number, which tells me that it is limited. It is limited. And there is a common thread that unites all of these situations using these numbers, and we'll get to it in a minute. Here's the verse we just looked at. The woman is in the wilderness. Not a very happy place to be. A place where the children of Israel wandered for 38 years, but God did what while they were in the wilderness? He watched over them. He protected them. He took care of them. And she has a place that God prepared out there in the wilderness so that she would be nourished for 1,260 days. So this woman is being persecuted. Being persecuted, but the persecution is limited to 1,260 days. It's not complete. It's limited. And it's limited by God. It was God who gave the beast the mouth speaking authority, speaking arrogant words, and God granted him only 42 months to carry out whatever God wanted him to carry out for him. So it's limited. It is limited. Now, what's the beast going to do during those 42 months? Does anybody know? He's going to persecute the saints. Okay? And that's all God's going to allow. Because it's 3.5, not 7. Verse 14, we looked at it. God provided this woman with two wings of the great eagle so that she could fly into the wilderness to her place where she was nourished for times, and half a time from the presence of the serpent. So she is still seen as being out there in the wilderness, being persecuted, having a difficult time, but God is doing what for her as she is out there? He's protecting her, taking care of her, providing for her. But we as readers know that the authority of the beast in Revelation 13:5 is proscribed or limited by this figure of 42 months. And we know that the woman's difficulties are also proscribed or limited by the figure of 1,260 days. Because that brings us back to 42 months, or 3.5 again. Let's go to Daniel for just a minute. And we're going to be looking at Daniel too. By the way, does anybody know the subject of Daniel 7? It's a vision where Daniel sees four animals, a lion, a bear, a leopard, and then he sees a fourth beast. And that fourth beast catches his attention. Verse 25, Daniel 7, let me get over here where I get my context. And this is the fourth beast that is under discussion. He, the fourth beast, will speak out against the Most High, who is God, and will intend to make, and wear down the saints of the highest one, that's Christians, wear down. And he will intend to make alterations in times and in laws, which is God's prerogative, by the way. And they will be given into his hand for times, and half a time.
This is what the Bible teaches against standard and the time change.
No. The Bible doesn't speak about time changes. As you're thinking about it.
It's an abomination, I think, that he's talking about.
Okay. Now, the time that the fourth beast, which I will tell you is Rome, almost everybody agrees with that. the fourth piece in Daniel 7 is wrong. And that's the one that catches Daniel's attention. And look how long he has got, or the situation, that he can wear down the saints of the Most High. It is limited, proscribed, a time, times, and half the time. It's the time of the persecution of God's people, but it's also the time when God protects his people as they undergo that persecution. And that is the common thread in every one of these. The period of the beast's authority, limited by God to 3.5. And what is he going to do with that authority but persecute God's people? But the 42 months tells you that God, with that figure, is going to take care of them during that 42 months, during that time. It's the period of the holy city being trodden underfoot, 11:2, where we are. Leave out the court, which is outside the temple, and do not measure it, because it has been given to the nations. God did the giving. He allowed it. And they will tread underfoot the holy city. Now, who is the holy city? Or what? It's us. It's us. They will tread underfoot the holy city for 42 months. Persecution, but God's protection along with it. Number 3, it is the period during which the two witnesses prophesy, which we will get to. It's in verse 3, and I will grant authority to my two witnesses. Now, who are the two witnesses going to turn out to be? The church of men. So we're going to use 3 or 4 figures in the first 3 verses of chapter 11, all as representative of God's people. And they will prophesy for 1260 days, clothed in sackcloth. Now, sackcloth indicates what kind of a position, what situation for the two witnesses. Mourning, grief, difficulty. Let me throw in the word that's always in there. Persecution. But does God take care of these two witnesses for those of you who have read ahead? Yes, he does. Do they go through some difficult times? Yes, they do. But God rescues them or takes care of them through that, and that's told to us by the 42 months. It is a period of persecution, but also of, if you like the word, protection. Okay? It is the period, verse number 4, of the woman who is nourished in the wilderness. Again, difficulty. Persecution. She's on the run. She's the church. And this mean old dragon is after her, but God provides for her by taking care of her in her place, out there in the wilderness. He doesn't bring her back in and set her in a palace. He leaves her out there to undergo the difficulty, but takes care of her in the same process. Jeannie?
That's what he answered your question. I wonder why it's nourished. Because it sounds to me like she's nourished in the wilderness and not persecuted.
No, she's persecuted or she wouldn't be in the wilderness. Okay, but while she's there, we have this God's care going on again. His protection. He's ensuring that she survives. Will some of them endure persecution? Yes. And some of them will die. But God is going to take care of his people, his church, no matter what. And that time frame, 42 months, 1,200, blah, 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 is an indication of that, because it's a common thread that runs through every one of the instances that I found where it's used. Persecution? Yes. But protection, yes. If the persecution is numbered by 7, what does that tell us? Suppose it was. Huh? It would never end. It would never end, because that's a perfect, complete, sacred number. It would never stop. 3.5 tells you that's only half there, And it's not going to be complete or perfect or forever lasting. It's limited. Any questions? Because it's used in the same way by Daniel, who was 600, 700 years before John was ever born. The same figure. So John does what he does through many places in Revelation. He picks out the imagery of the Old Testament prophets and brings it up to his time to describe the persecution and the protection of God's people back in his day. Persecution, protection. Not time. It's describing a state of affairs, a set of circumstances that exist when you see that number or that time frame used. Caesar, who was not the first emperor, by the way, the first emperor was Augustus. But he came into power guessing at about 50 years before Christ was born. So, that wouldn't be far off. But I hadn't heard that before. Rome collapsed in the 5th century, didn't she? Early part of the 5th century.
476.
Okay, that's the 5th century. 476. So she actually lasted closer to 500 years. But if you're using the term dominant, you probably got to take some off of that because she was reeling and much weakened there for the last maybe 100, 150, or 200 years. So that's a good thought.
The 3.5.
There's a 3.5. Yeah. Yep. Very good, Julie.
You wrote it down.
Yeah. Yep.
Lloyd, just to throw two more 3.5 at you. When Antiochus Epiphanes defiled the temple during the intertestament period, it took them 3.5 years to clean and purge it. And that's where your Feast of Dedication comes from. And then the siege of Jerusalem, total time, was 3.5 years.
Okay.
Vespasian started it, and then it was somewhat lifted, and then Titus.
Titus, your son. Yeah. Okay.
Look at the people who are the victims in these 5 situations. Every one of them are God's people. In every one of them, God's people are in difficulty being persecuted by the beast, trodden underfoot, number two. She's out in the wilderness all alone. Number three. It's the two witnesses prophesying in sackcloth, which tells you things are not good. And then the woman in the wilderness who was out there supposedly all alone at the mercy of this great dragon. Okay, and then in Daniel, it's the period the little horn, who is Domitian, persecutes the saints. So that runs all through every one of those. Every one of those. And in every one of those, God is going to protect his people. Okay, now, what is the origin of this? By the way, it goes, okay, we want to look at this. And we've already looked at that. And we've already looked at that. And we've already looked at that. Okay, let's go to the book. Well, you don't have to. I've already got that on the slide. We're going to ask, what is the origin of this figure? The first time that we have it used.
First Kings 17, 1 through 5. I believe this was used in this church building during the last week. Now Elijah, this was about 800 years before Christ. Now Elijah the Tishbite, who was of the settlers of Gilead, said to Ahab, who was the terrible king, "As the Lord God of Israel lives, before whom I stand, being I serve him, surely there shall be neither dew nor rain these years." How many? I don't know. "Except by my word." The word of the Lord came to me saying, "Elijah, go away from here and turn eastward and hide yourself by the brook Cherith, which is east of the Jordan. It shall be that you will drink of the brook as I have commanded. I have commanded the ravens to provide for you there." So he went and did according to the word of the Lord. For he went and lived by the brook Cherith, which is east of the Jordan. Do you see anything similar to what we've just been discussing with the 42 months? You've got persecution. What'd you say there?
Hiding in the wilderness.
Yes. Just like the woman. He is on the run from Ahab and his wife, who? Jezebel. So he's been persecuted. He's been run out of town. And he's out in the wilderness trying to hide and worried about his life, and with good reason. They were out to kill him. But what does God do for Elijah as he is out there in that wilderness, scared for his life? He provides and protects Elijah. That in mind. Jesus replies to this in Luke 4:25 in his hometown of Nazareth, I believe. "But I say to you, there were many widows in Israel in the days of Elijah when the sky was shut up for..." How long? How long? 3.5 years, 42 months, 1,260 days, times a half a time, when a great famine came over the land. So, persecution, protection, and what number do we find popping up again? 3.5. It wasn't used back in 1 Kings. Jesus told us that Elijah sent them in just these years. And Jesus tells us how many these years turned out to be. So, he was being persecuted, but also being protected and nourished. And how did God nourish Elijah, for goodness sake? Ravens brought him his food. He finds many ways to care for his people. Many, many, many different ways. Remember, 3.5 is a broken 7. 7 tells us about completeness and perfection. 3.5 tells us that we aren't close. Okay? And we got limitations with that. Ready to go to verse 3?
No questions.
No. What?
No questions.
Yeah, David.
Why person say, when someone tells you, "I've got revelations, I'll figure it out," that's when you just need to just nod and walk away. No one will this side of heaven. We won't figure it all out. And that's okay. Our hope is okay, so nobody will figure it all out. Except God wins.
Well, that's true. The whole thrust of the book is that God's people are going to be persecuted, but God's going to take care of the persecutor. Now you can boil it down to that. Yeah. And the persecutee. Yes, yes. Okay, what is the overall brush of the visions in verses 1 and 2? The city of God, the church of God, is to undergo persecution from Rome, and despite this, all the while the church will be protected by the Lord. I'll tell you what, let's just quit one lousy verse. We need to get one. I didn't even get one.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Yeah. Okay, because listen, 11:3 is going to give us another example of what we, and well, I've already brought them up, is going to give us another example of persecution and protection, but this time the image is changed from the temple, the city, from the temple in verse 1 to the city of God in verse 1. Now the people are under the image of the two witnesses who continue to prophesy in spite of the persecution. But the language used, don't let it trip you up. It's got a point, but it's, they don't ride down the street for 3.5 days. Any more questions? Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, we thank you for Jesus, for his willingness to come and die for us, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. We thank you for him. We thank you for this season which honors him. And we thank you for the blood that he shed and the love that he shows. And give us understanding and wisdom again in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you.